Another edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. Uncle Sam, his sous chef John Venere, and Uncle Sam, we are at the home of former NFL star Maaki Kemoeatu.
Well, I tell you what, not only is he a Super Bowl winner, but he's a generous guy, him and Chris.
And he's got a new kitchen.
That's right.
Let's go see it.
Let's go bless that kitchen.
After you.
All right, man. Thank you, Maaki. Thanks for having us.
Welcome. Come in.
Thank you.
I just moved in, so it's a new place. So.
Beautiful. Maaki, thank you for having us.
Thanks for coming.
You know how we're going to do this? We're going to go in your fridge. You're not nervous, huh?
No, I'm a little nervous. Just a little bit.
Whoa, my God. This is not leftover. This is the real deal.
Well, the fact that he's moved into a new house means a new kitchen, means freshly stocked refrigerator.
Oh, baby spinach.
Just barely moved in.
I might do a nice fruit salad. I can see this already.
Yeah.
You're all right with that, huh?
Yeah, I'm all right, man. You're like the defensive coordinator, offensive coordinator right now. I'm just...
Oh, but you play defense.
I play defense.
Hey, John.
You're trying to keep things healthy now, right?
Yes. You know, my brother and I had kidney surgery, and so now we're trying to stay really healthy.
Wow, man, John, these guys got the real deal here, man.
This is one of my favorites.
My father used to make me eat these.
That's my favorite too. Man, we got some major proteins in here.
I should have got something more healthy, like filet or something.
No, it's fine.
No,
he'll cook it good.
He'll cook it healthy.
We gotta keep this. I gotta do some blocking for you on this one. Well, I tell you what, I think we got it really, really seriously. I think we got enough to make the movie. We got salmon, protein. I think we got things to make this thing pop.
Yeah.
We're good to go.
Okay, Uncle Sam. So, Kraft and Heinz have now sponsored a new segment or a new item in our show, and it's the mystery box. The crew has called it Box Choy, and they have added items that we have to use in the show.
Let's bring it. Let's do it.
All right, Maaki, I'll let you open it and grab it out.
Welcome hard this way.
There you go.
It's okay, I can hold it like
What we got in there, Maaki? Oh, barbecue sauce.
Barbecue sauce.
Nice. You like that?
Oh, yeah. Who doesn't like barbecue, you know?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh man, perfect there for our salad dressing.
How's that?
We got cameras everywhere. Check it out.
Wow, man, we got a camera in there. Okay, let's look into it. Let's lead into it. Hey now.
Okay, Uncle Sam, lots of great stuff.
Well,
what
amazing.
Are we doing first?
There are a lot of healthy things in there. Yeah. Amazing.
No leftovers.
Yeah, no leftovers.
Good
man.
Job shopping.
Yeah, good job shopping. I want to make a fruit salad first.
Okay.
Japanese
pears.
Yeah, pears, some strawberries. Do me a favor, John. Okay. Can you go rinse them?
Sure.
They got holes on the bottom, so you just rinse them right in here.
Okay.
And let the water drip, and if not, keep it like this, trim upside down.
Okay.
So who did all the shopping? You?
Yeah, me. You know, trying to pick a lot more healthier.
Yeah. So let me ask you this: was it really? It wasn't a tough decision to give up a kidney for your family.
No.
It is a process, though, right? You guys have to lose weight or get healthier.
We have to get healthier. I have to get in shape. I think it took another year for me to get prepped and ready to be able to do the surgery.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, that was a nice speech that you folks gave at the Capitol, you and your brother. Had a lot of love there, you know, you folks gave back to the community, but...
I mean, there's not much that I wouldn't do for my brothers either. And no love like a brotherly love, that's for sure.
No. Yeah,
how many years ago was that?
That was 3 years ago.
3 years ago.
Yeah, oh. It was 3 years ago.
Pass me some of the berries.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
Kids like fruits?
Oh, love it. Love it. I'm coaching my kids up eating healthier. So far, so good. I mean, my son is only 3 months and he's 20 pounds already just by breastfeeding. So
wow.
I got to make some better choices for him coming up.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, man, this salad is pretty much done. I'm gonna add maybe some green just around to, you know, just to add it to it. But if we can look at this, man, it's just amazing.
Ah.
What do you think, Maaki?
Very nice.
I think there's something, this is a little off, like, it just, it's a little off balance.
I'm gonna put a little green around
here.
Glad
you picked that up.
Yeah. man. I don't know where you guys get your strawberries from, but where you gonna get them from? They're huge. So that's our first course right here. Look at this. Wow. And I'm gonna make a little dressing. You know, I'm gonna drizzle that French Italian if I don't use it in a regular salad.
Awesome. Nice.
Look at that. We're gonna get this going right here.
You see the pose? You see the pose? You're not in the pose right here.
So you know what I'm doing? I'm gonna cut off all the part that has the bamboo part of the asparagus.
Oh, right through the bag.
Right through the bag. So.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Yeah, so now this here, you save this, and you can also make like a soup, a cream of asparagus.
Really?
So you add little onions, you add little light chicken stock, you add these asparagus stems to it, and then you just let it come to a nice simmer. Then you let this go for a long time with just onions and some celery, and then you just strain it to a strainer. And then the broth is how you make your soup. And there's all kind of ways you want to cook this. Of course, the most latest, they take this, so they peel this all apart, and then they deep fry it, and they take something like a, not really good, a lot of sugar, but like maybe a balsamic drizzle, and then they serve that like that.
Oh, wow.
But we're not gonna do that. We'll just oven roast it. We're gonna take a little bit of, John, can you get some garlic salt back there?
Garlic salt, yeah. Thank you, John.
Yeah. Go deep, John.
I'm glad John's here, because I don't know what's gonna, you know, you do without me. I don't know football. I don't know how to work my way around the kitchen.
So I like to season it up a little bit.
It's a little bit of garlic. So you drizzled it with some olive oil?
Yeah, just so that the sodium attaches to it.
Okay.
And we're gonna just toss it lightly. And we're gonna go in the oven.
Okay. And it goes in the oven at what temperature?
370, 350, you're around there.
Okay. For how long?
About maybe 10, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, yeah. But I want to try to do something different. I've never done it before. Just a little bit on here. What do you think we're going to do, Monkey?
I think we want to do great.
I love it.
I love it, man. My kind of guy. All right. We'll put a double. We'll put a
wow.
Use.
Yeah. Hey, it's like a umu then, huh?
Yeah. John, put that on top.
Okay.
Wow. Okay. I like it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Put that some mushrooms. We just saw, because you know they
you're
just
creating. You're creating right now.
Yeah, because they just moved in, and it's important to try to bless the house.
Yes.
With food and good love and excitement.
Is this the first real meal that
you're having? Yes, it is.
Wow.
Wow, man.
Hey, Uncle Sam.
Well, first real meal.
But you know what's even
made
awesome?
By a world famous chef.
No, but Sam Choy. But he doesn't know it. But every time we cook in people's home, we sign their kitchen the wall. So Monkey, which wall you want me to sign?
Hey, you know what?
No,
I'm just kidding.
Do you even have a pen in the house?
Oh,
no.
We got a pen.
Oh, we're gonna get a pen.
No.
Right next to the Super Bowl.
Is it an apple pen or a pineapple pen?
Oh, pineapple pen. So how was it like that morning before the big game?
Oh, it's amazing. You know the. You worked your whole life to get into the NFL, and let alone you get a chance to play in one of the biggest games in the world, you know, in the Super Bowl. And butterflies are flying, you know, you've been practicing the last 2 weeks to be able to prepare for the game, you know, so it's an exciting time.
So 350 to 370, somewhere between there, for how long?
About 15 minutes.
All right.
Malky, you're gonna season this steak.
All right.
So I'm gonna do, just have you season on top here, you know, and turn it over.
Garlic salt?
Yeah, just garlic salt for now, because when I cook them, then I add the soy at the end.
Ah.
So that's when the flavor comes out really nice. Man, I like that wrist action, man. That's really good.
Hey, it's all in the wrist. All in the wrist, right?
Yeah, very good. You've done that before.
We got to flip these over like this?
Yep.
I've been watching your show, man. You've been practicing.
Oh, John's grueling.
I have
drew
that. You know what?
What do you mean, John?
Oh, those are some thick pieces of meat, boy.
John is a steak man.
Wow.
Okay.
So those are so big, they won't fit in that pan.
That's right. We'll just put two at a time. We'll put the other on there.
Okay.
We'll let it go. Basically, for like that kind of steak right there, to get mid-rare, you want to go like maybe 10 minutes aside.
10 minutes aside.
And then let it
for
rest.
Medium rare.
Yeah, medium rare, and let it rest.
Aloha. Here in Hawaii, there's not much debate when you're deciding between fresh or frozen seafood. The bounty of our oceans ensures an onalicious fresh daily catch. But what about those other varieties from distant shores? What do you choose, the fresh fish behind the counter or the frozen fillets in a bag? Well, it depends on how the fish was brought to shore. Commercial fishing operations have two options: store the fish on ice and bring it in within a few days, or freeze fish and return when the hold is full. Like any living food, a dead fish starts to decay right away. The ice will delay the process, but freezing actually stops the process and preserves the nutrients. Food distributors say if you can get fresh fish from the boat to the table in a day, it's a good bet. If you're not certain, frozen is a good alternative. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
Okay, so I want to get into the salmon. Do you like salmon?
I love salmon.
So I like to just cut, I like to serve the skin on it like this, because the flavor is really good.
I know you can bake it. What do you plan on doing with it today?
I want to bake it.
You are going to bake
it. I like baking it. I want to have Maaki season it again because he got the nice roll. And then I'm going to roll that right like this, Maaki.
Let me start the fan.
Roll that right now.
Oh.
John, you want to take the steak?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, take
turn it over.
Yeah.
Okay. It might be a little bit too hot.
Really? Let's see. Oh no, man. You bit the root, Chris?
Yeah.
And then put your magic. Let me check the
steak. A little drizzle.
Oh, perfect, John.
Pull it.
Oh
wow.
So this is gonna go right with the steaks. We'll cook that up there. Oh man, a little bit more on the, it's ready.
Yeah, it's almost ready?
Yeah, almost ready.
Okay, almost ready. How's that?
Yeah, it looks great. When you spend this kind of money for a steak like this, you don't want to go past medium. Just let it cook like that, John.
Okay.
Look at this, guys.
That looks really, really good. That's great cook.
Yeah, now just a little bit. I'll show you, man. They have that nice light sodium stuff. Okay, so just swoosh that around with a little bit of that. And that puppy is done.
Wow.
That steak is done.
I don't know what to do. Get my phone out, start recording. Or...
don't worry, they're capturing it all. Look at that. Oh, man. So Maaki has seasoned our salmon, okay? So that's going to go right on here, Maaki. Go ahead, take a picture. Put your salmon right there like that. Skin side
with
down.
With the skin.
With the skin. Down.
John's piece.
Yeah, John, your piece
right there. Give me the small one.
John, it's not that hot, John. Come
okay.
On. Okay, you got it?
Oh, I got it.
I'm gonna put some of the vegetables on here. Okay, now we have our two challenge items that we had by our sponsors. So they got the classic sweet and thick barbecue sauce.
Sweet and thick barbecue sauce.
Let's put the finger out, Maaki.
You first, sir. No, okay. Yep, yeah, I got it.
Maaki, you never get them.
That is sweet and thick.
It's good. It's good.
Wow.
You want to wash it off?
Please.
I mean, I don't mind, you know, but.
I want you guys to taste it.
You're just mixing that right up. I had a good scoop of
it. Yeah. Oh.
Woo! Two things you wouldn't think of mixing together. Like
no, that. I never thought of mixing that.
So I'm drizzling here.
Drizzle.
And then this one here, I want to just put around the bottom of that, so in case you don't want to have it all throughout. You got it, John?
As it's sizzling.
Pretty on this one. So you want to just kind of like move it around so the skin comes off. And we'll pick it up just like that.
Oh, that is a great trick.
John, we get lucky every now and then.
Oh man.
Wow. You know, a lot of people they don't care too much for salmon because they think it tastes like mud, but
mud?
The oil in the salmon is really good.
Yeah. I never thought salmon. I mean,
if you can eat tilapia from Wilson Lake, man, you can. You can eat tilapia. You can eat this. Okay, so just a little bit. The back of the spoon, Maki, just a little bit, just to glaze it. Maki, you hold that. This is your house. This is your kitchen. Look at this, guys.
Wow. Thank you. Man. Thank you so much.
Oh, no. Thank you for having
Sam,
us.
John, yeah. Been very blessed thank with you. Many things in my life, but winning a Super Bowl, getting to play in the NFL, and having you guys come over to my house and be able to cook this meal. I mean, it just gives me the chills because home-cooked meal is where it's at.
That's right. That's the
thank
best.
Thank you, Sam.
They had the goods.
Tell us about the first dish.
Well, we did the fruit salad, which was amazing. Fresh berries and, you know, the Asian apple. Humongous strawberries in there. They're growing big out there in Kauko.
Sure do, Sam. You know it.
And then, of course, we did an assortment of vegetables in the oven emu. The Brussels sprouts, the asparagus, had the little tip of the asparagus. And then we seared some steaks. Kind of smoked up the house. Sorry about that. The salmon, oven seared it, in the oven roasted. So I tell you what.
Can we?
Yeah, it's up to you.
Time to grind.
Go ahead.
I will start the serving. I'll pass this down.
Take your time.
My dad will be proud. I know that there's a story behind this massive table. You like big tables, and you said that there's a tradition and a little story behind being able to have a table like this.
I'm the oldest of seven kids, and you know, my dad's a minister. And growing up, the dinner table is always where, you know, the family would meet at the end of the day or early before everybody goes. Mm-hmm. And this is where my dad did a lot of his teaching to us, is when we sit down as a family and eat. And my dad always made sure that there was a big table to fit all seven kids and my parents. And so in getting this house, I wanted to make sure I get a big table for when, you know, I have my family and my siblings, because I learned a lot from my dad at the dinner table. You know, I'll share with you one time, you know, our family, we're a very poor family, and my dad worked like, you know, three, four jobs to be able to put food on the table. And for 1 week straight, I noticed that my dad was not eating. But when we come to the table, we'd have one whole chicken and then some taro and some ulu. And got to the second week, I asked my dad, why don't you eat? And dad said, no, you guys eat first. You know, you guys go ahead and eat. And I said, oh, okay. So we ate. And I didn't, that night, it bothered me, so I didn't go to sleep. So I went to bed, and I kind of snuck back in to see what my dad was doing, you know, afterwards. So what my dad was doing is, after we ate whatever was left over, my dad would gather it up, and that's what he would eat for the, you know, that night. And, you know, that's some one of the significance of this table. It's like my dad made sacrifices, you know, for us to be here. You know, my brother and I, we won the Super Bowls, and he won three Super Bowls and whatnot, but teaching like that, you know, of course, you know, Sam, we're both from the same place.
Right.
Kahuku, you know, local boy growing right. up. And so those are some of the things where I remember about the dinner table. Sacrifices family
right.
made and yeah. you know, learn and everything. Yeah.
Traditions.
So, sorry, getting a little choked up.
Thank you for sharing.
Yeah, yeah, really. I mean, it's an honor, and you know, to us being in your house. My dad and mom too work, you know, like day in, day out, you know, dark to dark, and you know, you kind of wonder, like early in the month, mm-hmm. oh man, you know, we had chicken, had nice meals. Yep. And at the end of the month, man, a lot of eggs and rice, you know. Yeah.
You guys, I want to just thank you so much for having us in your house, allowing him to cook and me to eat. But remember,
when Sam Choy's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Roll with the punches right here.
This is for me. And the salmon is for you guys. What are you doing with the salmon?
What well, the salmon is for you guys? Guy.
Oh, there, thanks.
John, you're the best, John.
Ed has moved from the couch to the stairs. He's ready to roll. Ed, by the way, is just off camera, waiting to pounce on that.
Okay, bring our salmon out.
No, you want the salmon?
I think we're gonna go naked.
Naked.
Yeah,
naked.
Right, right, no, we're going naked.
Yeah, just we're going right naked. We're going
naked.
What does going naked mean?
I don't know what school he went, but he loves steak.
What do you mean you don't know what school?
I know, just easy.
Yeah, dude.
You want? Come here, man. Why
not? Come here, man.
I'm surrounded by Kahuku guys.
When I talked to some of the St. Louis coaches and other ILH coaches, he said, come here, man. The best way to prep for them is bring the pow drum on the field. Come on, go, go, boom! All the linemen go down. Is that true, John?
No.
We gotta go watch John, though. I don't know. He's.
What do you mean? Why?
You're doing good, John.
Thank you.
And shoot it.